At times, you are surprised how nature has generously endowed our steppe homeland, Kazakhstan. And first of all, this is a unique geographical location and rich natural resources. If you visit Kazakhstan once, or at least fly over the country, you will understand how beautiful and diverse our land is. Kazakhstan is a place where a genuine miracle of nature, a wild tulip is growing, which gave birth to red Dutch tulips. The world's leading botanists and florists claim that it is Kazakhstan that is the home of tulips. So this fact is a convincing reason for anyone to want to visit this country of beautiful and free wild tulips, Kazakhstan. Kazakhstan has righteously become a place of pilgrimage for tulip fans from all over the world, just like Japan is for admirers of a blooming sakura, for example. Wild tulips is a genuine decoration of steppes in spring. The scene of tulips blooming in April is so magnificent and breathtaking. Tulips look so beautiful that one can lose the sense of reality. The steppe that was almost naked, with nothing on just yesterday, suddenly, one April morning, turns into this wonder of nature. Many people believe that Holland is a homeland of tulips. But in Holland, there are no wild tulips. All the tulips that grow there are reared artificially. The ancestors of most of these tulips come from Central Asia, and Kazakhstan in particular. The most famous among them is a Greig's tulip. Greig's tulip gave birth to nearly 300 different kinds of tulips. Our country is the richest in the number of various wild tulips, being home to 36 kinds of wild tulips. Most of them are very rare and need special protection and are included into the red list of threatened species. 8 species are unique for Kazakhstan and can be found nowhere else in the world. Everyone knows that tulips are flowers with no smell. However, they create a specific odor, odor of joy, odor of admiration, without which human beings cannot live. It's not a coincidence that blooming wild tulips is accompanied by the birds' trilling. It's possible that only birds can feel this secret odor of tulips, and that's what makes them sing so joyfully. And all this miracle comes from our steppe tulips. Our country has a very rich wild nature. Since its independence, the first time visitors started to know the existence of tulips. Special routes have been developed, and more people started to travel here. It's attracting more and more interest. I believe that our wild tulips is a good trademark, a good brand for our country.
Here, then I'll hike. inside and red on the outside. Tulips are grown in a broad area from China, Kazakhstan, Afghanistan, Iran, Turkey, Greece. And there it stops more or less. Some people say some wild tulips grow in Europe, but probably these are escape tulips. But the main center of tulips is, I think, in Kazakhstan. There, I don't know by head, but maybe at least 30 different kinds of the 87 kinds are growing there. Well, first, it is unique that, of course, Kazakhstan is a big country, so there are many tulips growing, many species. And as I said, most of the species cannot be grown in Holland, because in Kazakhstan it's very cold in winter and very hot in summer.
Only an evanescence of a blossom period might be disappointing, but this feeling is balanced when you think how lucky we are to be able to view and admire tulips, this perfect creation of nature, and that we should learn to appreciate our life and nature, and know that they are a passing, although a beautiful miracle. It feels as if tulips, through their beauty, appeal to us to love and preserve them as a symbol of freedom. This is exactly why our wild tulips are also called free. Stalklet works its way out through the center of a bulb, while buds burst out in April or May. Approximately in a month's time, the buds start to grow. Inside, they are separated into three nests with seeds in each other. Once mature, the nests open from top to bottom and the seeds spill out. The next spring, new young tulips appear, and it takes 10 to 15 years for them to blossom. A wild tulip is a special plant which was able to adapt and survive in specific arid climatic conditions. It has a very short life cycle in early spring when the soil has enough moisture due to frequent spring rains. The tulip has its underground part, a bulb, which can live for many years. Its life can be compared with the life of a human being. Our wild tulips proliferate through seeds, unlike real tulips that proliferate through their bulbs. Right now, I'm holding a leaf which is about 3 or 4 years old. It takes 12 to 15 years for the tulip to blossom and bear fruit for the first time. It may then bear fruits for 20, 30, or even 40 years. The lifetime of a tulip is about 60 to 70 years, just like of a human being. If you would like to understand the heart of Kazakhstan and its people, you will have to drive over 1,000 kilometers from the West Kazakhstan towards the famous Krasnaya Gorka in the South Kazakhstan and continue your journey up to the Aksu-Jabagli Reserve and further down to the East Kazakhstan. And this journey should take place in April, in the period when wild tulips blossom, so perfectly heightening the white and pink shades of cherries in blossom, the emerald green of the steppe grass, against the blue sky and snowy peaks of the Zaylisky Alatau. Only then you can appreciate all the beauty of Kazakhstan's nature and its unique geographical landscapes. And all through the way, you will be led by the king-like tulip in prime, filling your soul with a special trepidation in front of generosity and beauty of nature.
The only country I visited for tulips was Kazakhstan, so that already shows how important Kazakhstan is for tulips. During that 3 weeks I was there in 2008, I have seen 30 different kinds of tulips, of which 20 were in flower. I was there at the right time.
As early as in the middle of the first millennium AD, wild steppe tulips started their victorious parade along the Great Silk Road, and with the time, they spread over many countries. They first reached the court of celestial emperors, where they were respected as sacred flowers. Images of wild tulip may be seen among the decoration of the world-famous Taj Mahal, an architectural and iconic treasure which was built by the great Mongol Turkoman Shah Akbar for his beloved Mumtaz Hanim. In the southwest, the tulips reached the Arabian countries with merchant caravans, where they became decoration of palace gardens. In Europe, tulips appeared in the courts of the Muslim governors. Later, the shipboards of Venice merchants transported them to Holland, giving rise to a real tulip boom among wealthy families. It's enough to say that they were ready to pay a fortune for a bulb of tulip. Some of them would face bankruptcy, but would give away the shirt of back for this exotic and beautiful flower. Thus, a wild steppe tulip started to be reared in Holland, to become the grandsire of thousands of Dutch species of the most incredible colors and shapes to win the whole world.
Tulipa greiki is one of the original Kazakh tulips, what is growing in Holland too. There are a lot of hybrids from it. Mostly garden tulips, not for the cut flower industry. And tulipa, the other one is Kaufmanniana. And in the ancestors of all the tulips, what is growing is Tulipa schrenkii. It's also from Kazakhstan, also from Europe, but it grows from the Black Sea coast to Eastern Kazakhstan. The group of tulips, that are the Kolpakovskiana tulips. There grow a lot of tulips in Kazakhstan, they are a member of that group. I think all the tulips are originally from that group of tulips.
I've grown tulips my whole life. I've done it with my father in my younger years. My father has died 15 years ago. I'm going on with tulips. We do it many years. And mostly I use the tulips for my own business to make the flowers. The bulbs, when I grow up to make a little bulbs, then I put it in the ground. Then I till 3 years, then I grow big enough. Big enough for to make good flowers of good quality. The first tulips I come from Kazakhstan. And then they come here about 1500, I think. So the travelers, they take tulips away to here, and we growing on. We crossing together, and then we make more tulips, another colors. That's the history of the tulips here in Holland. But they come from Kazakhstan and Turkestan, Abadjan, from that side.
There are lots of legends and mysticism around the tulip. The sacred secret of the tulip is also kept in the bud of the flower itself. With its perfect form, closed at dawn, opened at noon, and closed again at the sunset. Such nature of the flower was associated with the human life cycle. No matter how people admire the Dutch tulips, their numerous colors and noble shapes, the Dutch tulips will always miss something that wild tulips of Kazakhstan have. Steppe tulips grow in the wild, and they still preserve this pristine spirit. One could just imagine, for a moment, how strong these delicate and vulnerable plants should be to survive all the cataclysms of nature and severe, sharp, continental climate of the great steppes. And all of this just to delight us, the modern people, and teach us how to remain free and faithful to our dear motherland. This is an adult plant. Here is a bulb covered with scales. Scales come out and reach the surface of the soil. It looks like a stalk is dressed in a stocking. This way, it's protected against drying out and freezing. It's neither hot nor dry. This kind of protection is typical for desert species. These are two plants. One is young and the other is old. The bulb of the young plant is lengthy and the bulb of the adult plant is mature.
А у этого каждый год на одном и том же месте, она уже не углубляется, это уже взрослая.
This specific beauty is unique for just wild tulips growing in our country. And tulips that are reared for commercial sale are deprived of this beauty. No matter how long they are reared in the garden frames, and no matter how beautiful they are in their own way.
The tulips we grow, you can divide in two kinds. Those that are used for the cut flower market, that's are maybe 90% of the tulips, and tulips that are grown for the garden, small ones. The small ones are crosses with Tulipa Kaufmanniana and Tulipa Greigi from Kazakhstan. The big ones that are used for the cut flower markets are hybrids between Tulipa Schrenkii, that grows from the Krim in southern Russia to the north of Kazakhstan. Has a very large area where Tulipa Schrenkii grows. It has supplied most of the colors. I have seen them close to Astana in all kinds of colors, a single species.
Wild tulips of Kazakhstan are to be viewed in the natural landscape. during the short time of their natural blossom, and the scene makes you appreciate how beautiful life is in its fragility. Our tulips teach you to understand the eternity. When you see a wild tulip for the first time in a steppe, blown over with a light wind, you may think, what happens to it if a strong wind blows? Because a tulip looks so delicate. But it surprises us again. During a storm, the tulip closes its petals in a perfectly shaped bud, and the strong wind cannot hurt it. Oh, how wise the nature is, and how merciful it is to its creatures, that it taught the tulip to be wind-resistant. A complete mystic might assume that a tulip learned naturally to withstand bad weather and to preserve its seeds against premature falling out. In other words, a tulip, just like a human being, has this instinct of self-protection. This might be a reason why, since in ancient times, a tulip have been attributed some mysterious features, some internal magic or spirit. I tell everyone that we should preserve this. This is a unique property of our country. It is our wealth. People of our country see this wealth and take it for granted. But visitors from other countries look at it and have tears in their eyes, saying, what an immense country you have here. What immense millions of wild tulips you have, which exist nowhere else in the world. We should preserve this, not just for the sake of beauty, but for our future generations to be able to use this natural wealth for the benefit of the country. Just like with our apple tree, which is the stem mother for all apple cultivars. Just like our Greig's tulip, Kaufmann's tulip, and Schrenk's tulip, that are the grandsires of hundreds of tulip cultivars. That is why this is our wealth. This is our pride. You know, wherever our tulip traveled throughout ages of its wandering, when it passed the Great Silk Road, warmed by human hands and warming with its beauty the tired soul of a man, and when it changed ships and crossed the seas, dazzling everyone with its magic beauty, and when it kept all the colors of universe in the center of its bulb, and then, in due time, gave out this fantastic fairy show to its tender, delicate petals. It is then that our tulip became the king of all flowers and a symbol of thousands to come and long-awaited springs, crowning the love itself with its unique, beautiful bud, with its ardent heart here in the Kazakh land.